Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Scandinavian Design 101. I'm Sanna.
I'm Andreas, and we're two Swedes, and we love design. Mm. And this week, we're going to show you our top 10 funky-looking chairs.
That's the only way to describe them.
Yeah.
They're funky-looking.
They're funky-looking, and you will start.
Mm. I will start with the Jan Ekselius resting chair, Etcetera. Mm. Designed in 1970 for JOC, is that how you say it?
Yeah, JOC. Jan O. Karlsson.
Mm-hmm. Okay. An old man's name.
Yeah.
It's a great example of Swedish futuristic looking design introduced in the late 60s as a reaction against the clean and simple lines of the 50s. The father of Jan Ekselius, Carl Erik Ekselius, was also a furniture designer, but his furniture were all made in the traditional Scandinavian style. The Etcetera chair was first exhibited at the Swedish Furniture Fair in 1971 and was available in two different versions, the resting chair Etcetera and the easy chair Etcetera 2. It was indeed inspired by a chair designed in 1969 by the two Swedish designers Jan Dranger and Johan Hult. But the Etcetera has a more elaborated shape, making it look cooler and more comfortable to sit in. Yeah. And it is comfortable, and I love it. Oh, freaking love it.
Yeah.
You're gonna bleep that, right?
Yeah, bleep. And that's perhaps the coolest chair produced in Sweden. Yeah.
It is.
And now let's go to a chair not produced in Sweden. The Eero Aarnio plastic chair tomato, mm-hmm. or tomato, depending on if you... designed in 1971 for Asko in Finland. Mm-hmm. In the 60s, Aarnio started experimenting with organic edgeless furniture constructed from fiberglass. And not edgeless when it comes to how they look, but edgeless, they have no corners.
No corners.
Now, and after designing the Pastilli chair in 1967...
That's also cool.
Yeah, that's a very cool chair. He continued to develop the concept, and a couple of years later, he launched the tomato chair. And at the first glance, it might look a bit complicated, but it's actually just constructed from three orbs, with two orbs as armrests and one stretched out to form the back. As most of Aarnio's furniture, the tomato was designed to be used both indoors and outdoors. And in the summer, it can be used on the water as a floating vessel. And in the winter, one can use it as a sledge gliding down the hill. And that's, I mean, extremely cool.
Doesn't it break if you do that?
No, it doesn't. It's fiberglass. It's almost unbreakable. I used to own a Pastilli, and I was tempted many times to use it out in the snow.
I've never seen anyone do that, though.
I've seen some old pictures of Aarnio himself and his kids. And they were playing out in the water these furniture.
Moving on.
Moving on.
Next one is my favorite chairs of all times.
Yeah.
Can I say that? Yes,
I can. Yeah, yeah.
It's Terje Ekström's easy chair Ekstrøm. Extreme in English.
Yeah.
Designed in 1973 for Hjellegjerde.
Hjellegjerde. Yeah.
Norwegian. It's a Norwegian example of a futuristic looking chair designed in the same period as the Etcetera chair I just talked about. But at the time, it was impossible for Ekstrøm to find a company willing to produce the strange-looking chair. And it remained a prototype until Hjellegjerde started producing it in 1983. It was distributed by Stokke and was exhibited at a lot of different furniture fairs around the world during the 80s. It's made from steel covered with foam plastic and was available in many different colors.
Yeah.
And I must have one in my life.
Yeah, and I think it looks like some kind of animal almost, like an insect.
No, or like a spider.
Like a spider, but it's extremely cool.
Haha, extremely.
Yeah. And now let's talk about Peter Opsvik and the chair Garden.
Because Opsvik made a lot of crazy stuff.
Yeah, I mean, I would like to look inside his head, because that's a lot of crazy stuff in there, I guess.
I think so.
And designed in 1985 for Stokke Fabriker, Norway. And in the late 1970s, Norwegian designers started questioning the stereotypical idea of the proper way of sitting.
Mm.
And according to Opsvik, we were forced to sit in the same position at work, at home, in the car, at the bus, well, like everywhere.
Mm.
And that was a problem, causing pain in the body and stiff joints.
Mm.
As a statement, he started constructing a wide range of different chairs, questioning the common assumption of what the chair actually is.
Mm.
And one example is Garden, produced by Stokke. And sometimes Opsvik is accused of designing chairs impossible for everyday use.
Like this one.
Yeah. But personally, he doesn't care about this and explains the idea behind the chair with this quote. Its purpose was to arouse sympathy for a freer use of the body. Garden was developed more as a message.
Mm.
And I think that's how we should understand the chair garden. I mean, it's supposed to be a weird-looking chair. Because, I mean, I've tried one out once, and it's the only chair I've seen where I couldn't understand when I saw it how to sit in it.
And that's the point.
Yeah, so I really like it.
Me too. Next up is Verner Panton's chair sitting wheel. Designed in 1974 as a prototype, Verner Panton was indeed the master of funky-looking furniture, and the sitting wheel is indeed one of his most innovative creations. It's a kind of a rocking chair, and the round frame makes it possible to sit in many different positions. A movable neck cushion made the experience more comfortable. Prototypes were manufactured by the German company Metzeler Schaum.
Yeah, Metzeler Schaum. Mm. Yeah.
But sadly, it remained a prototype and was never put into serial production. We just had to have it in this episode because it's literally a wheel.
Yeah, it is a wheel.
That you sit in.
And it's I mean, also, if you wanted to look inside Opsvik's head, you want to look inside Verner Panton's head, because that's also some weird ideas in there.
Very.
And then, a more traditional designer, Nanna Ditzel, chair Sommerfugle. And designed in 1990 for her own workshop. Nanna Ditzel was a versatile Danish designer who graduated from the Royal Danish Academy of Fine Arts in Copenhagen in 1946. And during her long career as a designer, she designed everything from like furniture, jewelry, tableware, textiles, almost anything.
Mm.
And later in her career, she developed the prototype chair Sommerfugle in her own workshop. And the name means butterfly in Danish, and it's not hard to understand why it was given that name. The sitting shell was made from fiberboard veneered with maple, resting on 6 thin tubular steel legs.
Mm.
And it's a beautiful chair.
It is.
And I also like the name Sommerfugle. It means summer bird. And it's a nice word for butterfly.
In
Swedish we say fjäril.
That means nothing.
No, it means nothing. Yeah.
Moving on again. I'm going to tell you about another Verner Panton chair. The multi-purpose chair Phantom.
Mm.
Designed in 1998 for Innovation Randers.
Yeah,
what is that?
Strange name for a company.
Is it? Okay.
Yeah, it's.
It was the last chair designed by Panton, the same year as he passed away, actually. It's an organic looking piece of furniture constructed from blow molded recyclable plastic. Intended for a multi purpose use, it can be used as a bench, chair, table, or just a funky looking sculpture.
Yeah.
The material made it possible to also use the chair outside, like Aarnio.
In the garden, yes.
Wherever you want.
Yeah.
And I also want one of these.
And I think it looks almost like a worm.
It looks like a worm, but I love it.
Yeah, it's a nice piece of furniture.
Mm.
And now, something completely different. It's the Stabbestol by Gustaf, And they were designed and created in the late 19th and early 20th century. And Fjæstad was a Swedish artist born in Stockholm in 1868. And early in his career, he worked for the painter Bruno Liljefors, all Swedes have heard about him, and would somewhat later become an apprentice of the famous Swedish artist Carl Larsson.
You all heard of him.
Yeah. And above being a painter, he was also a skilled craftsman, not Carl Larsson, but Fjæstad. Yeah. And he built furniture as well as violins. And specially appreciated were his chairs, the so-called Stabbestolar. And Stabbe, it means something like chopping block in old Swedish.
The thing you chop wood on.
Yeah, the thing you chop wood on. And they were an attempt by Fjæstad to create an Art Nouveau version of an ancient Swedish chair. And he made all the carvings himself using knife, chisel and plane. And the whole chair was then carved from a single piece of pine wood. And that's quite cool.
It is.
And they look quite crazy.
Quite and quite.
Yeah.
Next up is yet again Eero Aarnio. He did a lot of fun looking things.
Yeah.
And this time we're going to talk about the hanging chair bubble. Designed in 1968 for Asko again, Aarnio designed the bubble chair to be a transparent version of the fiberglass ball chair. When he couldn't design a transparent pedestal, he decided to let the chair hang from the ceiling instead. As with the ball chair, it has a unique acoustic, making it a cocoon shielding the rest of the room. So it sounds weird when you...
Yeah, you don't hear anything. It's just like if you have two glasses onto your ears.
I was thinking headphones, but okay.
Yeah.
The silver-colored leather cushions gave it the right futuristic space age look.
Yeah, it's as much space age as it gets.
It is.
And it's seen in a lot of movies and so on. So it's a great piece of furniture.
It is.
And now, last, we're going to talk about more contemporary piece of furniture. It's the Concrete by Jonas Bohlin. And designed in 1981, it was Bohlin's degree project when graduating from the art school Konstfack in Stockholm. And the whole chair was constructed from two plates of concrete and a bent piece of tubular steel. And when exhibited in 1981, it wasn't said to be a chair, but a sculpture. But the year after, the furniture company Källemo produced a limited edition of 100 copies, selling them as chairs. And it's been debated why Bohlin chose to produce such an uncomfortable and highly unpractical chair. It's often seen as a statement against the functional and modernist furniture his predecessors had designed.
And it's something new, it's fun.
Yeah, it's something new and it's a typical 80s postmodernism thing. Yeah, but I do like it. It's a funny piece of furniture, but you can't sit on it actually. No, it's extreme.
But you can't sit in any of these.
No, you can't.
Well, some of them.
Yeah. And that was our 10 funky chairs.
Funky looking
chairs. Yes. And I hope you liked this video.
Yes. And if you did, please click thumbs up.
And subscribe
if you haven't already.
And yes. And follow us on Instagram. We are called Scandinavian Design 101. Thanks a lot for watching.
Thank you.